Yo, what is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. And today, I got a video for you guys. Today, I'm going to be reviewing the first episodes of Fiona and Cake. Now, you guys know that today, what's called the show actually aired on Max. And well, honestly, I'm not gonna lie, I did actually, when I first watched the two episodes, like, it was actually pretty good. Now, if you guys have not heard of the show, well, I'm going to give you guys a recap. So, here you go. Alright, so literally last year we got the announcement that like we're actually beginning another spin-off since the last spin-off Distant Lands came out in 2021, and it was actually a mini series to go and cap off the ending of Adventure Time. But with Fiona and Cake, like, this will actually be a spin-off centering on the two variants of Finn and Jake from the show. And well, literally, if you guys don't know that, both Fiona and Cake actually did appear in the show, but they only played major roles, like what's called in the episode, like throughout the series. And then until now, they finally got their own show. And honestly, like, once when I first watched the first two episodes, they were pretty great, because literally at episode one, we're actually introduced to Fiona. Her real name is Fiona Campbell, and also her cat Cake. And also, well, throughout the episode, we do actually get to see the other variants of the characters from adventure from the show. And then in episode two, we also get introduced to Simon Petrikov, aka Ice King, who actually ends up, you know, struggling with, you know, being a human, etc. And then till now, like, he literally ends up making a desperate measures to go ahead and actually go back to, you know, like, to how things were. But alongside, I'm actually gonna go break down and analyze the Easter eggs in the first and also second episode. Basically, the first episode had a lot of Easter eggs, so I'm gonna go and dive into it. So yeah, but alongside, let's go and dive in. So here we go. Our starting off, we actually got is episode one. And well, in the first episode, we know actually seeing what's called Fiona and Cake actually what's called fight against a kind of a buff dog. And then, like, literally towards the end of it, they end up defeating it, but it turns out that Fiona was just, you know, having a dream and stuff like that. And then after that, well, we're actually introduced to what's called getting ready for work and stuff like that. And also introduced to Cake. And well, just to let you guys know that in the first episode, like, literally the show actually takes place, you know, in the, I would say, the real world. But literally, you guys do know that this is actually a different universe. And plus, since literally, if you guys aren't aware that the show will involve the what's called Fiona Cake going into the multiverse. So yeah, basically, if you guys do not know that, well, the show will go into the multiverse. So basically, I guess that going back to Adventure Time, it seems that both Fiona and Cake, well, there was an episode where Ice King ends up meeting the real Fiona. And well, literally, it turns out that she was just, you know, just an old lady and stuff like that. But literally, like, the episode does reveal that, like, literally that Fiona Cake was actually somehow an old show. But till now, basically, since literally with Fiona and Cake, it seems that the Fiona and Cake are actually, you know, real, and basically they're actually, you know, in different universe. And well, literally in the show, Fiona and Cake and also Simon will end up traveling to the multiverse, because like they're actually going to be, you know, fighting against a threat. So like which is actually pretty interesting. But going back, so Fiona ends up actually, you know, getting ready for work and stuff like that. Then suddenly Cake started experiencing something weird, where she ends up seeing literally through her eyes, she ends up experiencing some like supernatural stuff or whatever, or literally she ends up seeing like what's called some glowing, you know, whatever. And then basically literally throughout the episode, she, like, literally gonna see her go through that towards the end, like, you know, it's whatever. But yeah, like, literally throughout the episode, we're gonna see Fiona doing her regular day. And then, well, alongside, like, in this scene where she ends up working as a bus tour person or whatever. And basically, well, literally, like, in that scene, we do get some some other characters that actually kind of reference the characters from Adventure Time. Like, what's called, like, for example, we end up seeing this this person who actually references the wizard from the episode Wizard's Battle. And also, like, literally, yeah, like, that's also a reference. And also, we get a reference to Tiffany, because, like, literally, there's a character who actually gotta says Tiffany's, you know, catchphrase. And in the episode, we see this character who ends up referencing Tiffany. And then alongside, we do get what's called the return of Marshall Lee. And yes, he does actually return, and he's yet again voiced by Donald Glover. And yes, basically, he's back voicing the character. And also, well, after that scene, well, like, literally, we also see some, vision again. And then also, there's also a scene where Fiona passes by a statue, which actually kind of references Betty, who is Simon's fiance, and then well, literally towards the end of that scene, well, we end up seeing Fina was heading towards a cafe where he ends up meeting the other character who's actually Prince Bubblegum, but I guess in this universe he isn't actually a prince because it takes place in the real world, and well, he actually works at a what's called bakery, and then literally what's called after that, we also see Marshall Lee again, and the both of them end up actually what's called discussing, and then Marshall Lee ends up helping out Fiona to go and cure cake, and then she ends up going on a journey where she ends up going into a guardian forest or whatever, and then literally we end up actually meeting the other version of what's called a Lumpy Space Princess, and well, literally this version ends up helping Fiona what's wrong with cake, and then suddenly, well, what's called out of nowhere, Cake starts what's called seeing the vision, then she starts chasing it, then suddenly it lands into a ice cream car, and then that's where she falls in, and then that's where the episode ends. So yeah, and they have, guys, so that was episode one, and honestly, like episode one was actually kind of pretty good. I mean, good we know actually getting an introduction to Fiona and also Cedra, but literally after that, well, going into episode two, well, which is actually titled Simon Petrikov. So in the episode, we end up getting introduced to Simon, where he does, his what's called goes through his day and whatever. And then literally we end up finding out that he's actually in a human, what's it called, like, well, what's called a human habitat or whatever. And then basically, well, towards the end of it, he ends up what's called he ends up getting sick of actually what's called I was struggling being a human. Basically, we see that what's called throughout the episode where Simon struggles, try to adapt that into the human habitat. But literally, since like if what's called since literally basically towards the ending of Adventure Time, well, if you guys don't know that Ice King gets turned back into Simon, and basically, well, literally Betty ends up sacrificing herself to go ahead and save the land of Ooo. And then basically, we'll jump to Fiona and Cake. Well, literally, Simon actually struggles with the loss of Betty, and then basically, well, literally he tries to what's called he literally ends up what's called ends up struggling throughout the episode. Well, literally, so moving on, so literally in the episode we end up seeing what's called Simon actually end up heading what's called end up actually arriving at what's called kind of work of a bar place, and then basically we end up what's called I don't know where we see the return of Finn, and yeah, basically Finn does make a return, and then literally he actually looks older, and then alongside you guys are speaking about Jake. Well, basically Finn does mention that Jake actually is not here, it's not actually what's called it's not actually what's called it's actually what's called God, and yeah, basically it seems that probably Jake what's called somehow passed away before the events of what's called the show. And honestly, well, since literally with the show takes place, I guess further into the future, with that literally basically seems that what's called the show, well, literally the show takes place, I guess, well, probably a few what's called it literally what's called takes place years after what's called Distant Lands is basically what's called like Finn is actually older, so yeah, basically it takes place more into the future. What's called takes place way into what's called it takes place way into the future, and then like we know actually what's called in the episode Simon ends up actually discussing about of what's called his struggling as a what's called as a human, and basically well literally what's called Finn ends up bringing up the Fino and Cake stories that he actually what's called the Ice King actually did, since basically in the episode Simon actually kind of does not want to discuss about the Fino and Cake because literally he said, oh yeah, that's actually Ice King, but literally basically seems that well Simon does actually confess like how he feels, say, oh yeah, like literally I can adapt to this what's called of being a human, also I cannot adapt to the what's called to the what's called to the others, and basically well literally Finn ends up deciding to cheer Simon up by actually going on an adventure, and also just to let you guys know that this adventure that Finn takes Simon, it literally looks pretty cool, because if you guys don't know that this show was actually rated as kind of more of an adult show, and yeah, basically you guys will note that in the first two episodes we see the characters kind of curse, and yeah, I'm not gonna lie, it's kind of pretty interesting that these characters are cursing now, and basically, well, I'm not like, well, just to let you guys know, they don't actually curse a lot, but they just what's going to just say what's going to just whatever, but like in the and also speaking and also moving on from that, basically in the what's called in the what's called basically in the scene where like Finn and Simon go on an adventure, basically just to let you guys know that this episode does have blood, and yes, like basically it seems that the show is taking that route or what's called or whatever, and yeah, basically in the episode two we end up seeing well what's called Finn taking down this beast, and yeah, like honestly not gonna lie, it's just ugh. And then also we get another scene where Simon fights a bear, and basically he ends up getting a cut in his arm, and yeah, basically it does not look good, but literally Finn ends up taking out the was called the bear was just snapping his neck, and also yeah, like I'm not gonna lie, it's pretty brutal or whatever. But moving on, so yeah, literally towards the end of that was called adventure, Finn and Simon end up actually leaving it. Then after that, well, Simon ends up heading back to the human, what's called city, and then after that he ends up heading back home. Until once when he decides to, he ends up actually picking up the Phenom and Cake book, and then basically he decides to go ahead and actually try to resurrect Betty. What's called from, you know, the what's gonna try to resurrect Betty, and then basically literally what's called out of nowhere, like as soon as when his plan actually was about to work, it ends up screwing up, and then suddenly out of nowhere a portal on top of Simon's head ends up opening, and then out of nowhere Kate comes out, and then after that basically, well, what's called the episode ends, we end up seeing a remote, which actually what's called where a purple button pops up, but then after that, well, that's where the episode ends. So yeah, but anyway, moving on. And there you have it, guys. So look, that's a breakdown analysis of episode 1 and 2. And honestly, not gonna lie, this show was actually pretty good because it did actually kind of, you know, brought back the tone of how, you know, how the show was. And honestly, I'm not gonna lie, this show kind of like it literally brings it back to, like, you know, to the show, like literally when it was called stuff like that. And honestly, yeah, like the show was pretty good. And also, I did actually kind of and also speaking about the show, basically the show does actually, you know, references some other characters from the. What's called from the show, like for example, we do get some references to what's called to Lemon Grab, and basically, well, and there's a scene where what's called two ladies who are actually kinda are who kind of actually references both Lemon Grab and also the other Lemon Grab. Yeah, not gonna lie, that was kind of whatever. And also, alongside towards the end of episode 2, well, Simon calls Marceline, that basically the two what's called her and Prince Bogle are actually getting tattoos, and also there's the scene where, like, you know, it's just whatever. But alongside, yeah, basically the show is. What's called pretty good. And also, if you guys have not seen the show, I highly recommend you guys to go and watch it, because they're gonna be airing the next episode next Thursday. And well, what's called literally gonna be airing the next episode next Thursday. And well, literally, let's see, like, what's called, where does the story continue? So yeah, but anyway, moving on. Well, there you have it, guys. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. Go ahead and subscribe, turn on the notification, and I'll see you guys later.